Brought to you by a paid advertisement for Talespire.
Rejoice, for you behold the High Devil's greatest creation, the Coffee Lock. Most of us were created by the High Devil Redit. He seeks those with sorcerous origins and blesses them with magic of the pact. There are some of us which are created by Celestials, but after a few levels, they get pretty intense.
God said he'd teach me karate.
So, Beevil, how does a coffee walk?
A coffee walk lurks by using flexible casting to turn sorcery points into regular spell slots. Then we convert pack slots into sorcery points. Then we refill our pack slots with a short rest without losing any of the spell slots from flexible casting. And we repeat this process over and over, gaining more spell slots every time. Oh, also, we can use it to get a hold of spell slots that we shouldn't be able to for our level.
That seems like it shouldn't work rules as written.
Rah, more like roasted, my friend. I'm gonna get you some coffee. You wanna brew, my little bro?
Yes, please leave frame.
We're gonna be the brew boys.
All right, now that we're alone, do coffee locks work rules as written? I think it's a gray area. Coffee locks, to me, seem like they do work rules as written because the official position is that Divine Smite can use pack slots and it's similarly worded to flex casting. J. Cross said that you could interpret the section on multi-class pact magic as meaning pack slots can only be used by its spells and not by abilities, but he's saying could and not should. And it also is a little inconsistent with the Divine Smite, so I think rules as written it works. Common sense? You absolutely would be within your rights as a DM to say no to this. The really bad part, and the reason it's called a coffee lock is that players often argue that they can chain short rests instead of taking a long rest, which means that every time that the group takes a long rest, the coffee lock creates 16 more spell slots.
But Xanathar, that googly-eyed motherfucker, oh, he added some new rules.
For every 24-hour period that you don't take a long rest, you need to make a constitution save of each day you haven't taken a long rest times 5 plus 10, and if you fail, you gain a level of exhaustion.
Which I guess isn't so bad, but it does mean I don't have infinite spell slots. People say that if you're a Warforged, or if you have Aspect of the Moon, you don't have to worry about these things. Sleep and rest are different mechanically, so I'm sorry to break the news. Aspect of the Moon actually makes it more challenging to chain rest. Think about it.
So, if you really don't want to rest, you gotta go Coke Lock. That's a thing where you make a deal with an angel or a unicorn that allows you to make cocaine. To do the Greater Restoration spell. Thanks for watching this animated spellbook brought to you by paid advertisement for Talespire. Talespire is my favorite VTT. It's the only way that I play D&D online, and it doesn't handle systems, but it does handle maps, miniatures, map building, and movement better than any other VTT on the market, in my opinion. It's finally in early access on Steam, so you can buy it through a link in the description.